everyone. Welcome to part three of my paranormal experiences. So, the next experience is going to be about when I was 12, coming up 13, and I was with some friends, and they decided to want to do a Ouija board. But this was their own, the glass and some paper. And I said, hell no, I'm not even going to bother doing it. I just sat, you know, away from them and just let them do what they want. They turned the lights off and stuff. It would be girls and boys there. We'd be drinking and having a Chinese because we slept over at this girl's house. She was one of my best friends at the time. And weird things would happen. There'd be bangs. The lights would go out. It'd be really, really creepy. And the boys, they were scared so much, they ran up the house. They would not come back into the house. And there's us girls, petrified, but we had to stay there, you know, because we couldn't go home, because we promised our friend that we'd stay there. And they just stopped then. And it was creepy, because these noises was coming from everywhere around the house. And I assumed it'd be people pranking, but there was no one upstairs at all. And it was neighbours, because the neighbours are not type to bang like that. Then it comes to the time we went to bed, all the lights was off and everything, loads of people went asleep, and I stayed up because I was scared, because the experiences that was going on with the noises and the lights going off, I was too scared. I think it was within 5 minutes of everyone being asleep, I seen this dark figure in the doorway, and it was all in black, and it was a woman, and she had like a black veil on as well, and she was just staring at me, and I was petrified. So I grabbed the quilt and put it over my head, and I was crying, you know, a little bit tears and that coming to my face, you know, panicking, and everyone's still asleep, I didn't know what to do, but I managed to wear myself out, and I went to sleep. And when I woke up then, it was nothing. It's like no figure there, no noises, nothing. Everything was just back to normal. So that was another scary experience I had with my friends. Another experience I had was with my mother. And we got in a very heated argument. And because I'm a Catholic, I had to have a photo done of me in my dress for like my baptism, you know, my baptism. Holy Communion type of thing, and because the argument got really heated, the photo I had of me in that dress, I was praying, it started going side to side on its own pretty fast. Me and my mum looked at it and looked at each other and thought, what on earth just happened? You know, we were pretty freaked out because no one was near it, no draft. The picture was fine on the screw, on the wall and everything. It was fine. But the only thing I could think of was a God, you know, warning. I thought it could have been, because I'm a God's child, and because I'm, you know, with the church and I'm a Catholic, I assumed it would have been God. But, I don't know to this day. So that was another freaky experience, me and my mum, my dad together. There was another time then when I was living in my first home with my daughter and my partner at the time. And we'd walk from the living room into the dining room, and we could hear this gentleman talking, but couldn't pinpoint what he was saying. So we went in there and there was no one in there. Check the kitchen, no one was in there. Check the toilet downstairs, no one was in there. That baffled us and that freaked me out. I thought, oh my God, what the hell's in the house? Like, hearing the man's voice and no one there. So that was another cringy experience I had. And another experience then was in that same house. I was washing the dishes and my partner's mum at the time over to look after my eldest daughter while I'd done some tidying up in the house. So it's three rooms downstairs and a bathroom. So it's the living room, the dining room, and kitchen and then a toilet. So they were in the living room, no one was in the dining room, and it was just me in the kitchen. So I was washing the dishes, and all of a sudden I could hear the noise going off in my daughter's walker. And I looked in, and there was no one there. So I thought that was a bit weird. Why would that go off on his own? Started washing dishes again, and as I turned to look in there, the walker just went straight across the middle of the living room, and it was at a pretty fast speed, and the noise was still going, and I started to get freaked out. So I looked in again, there was no one in there, and I went and seen my daughter and her nan, which is my partner at the time's mum, and they wasn't in there, and I told them, and obviously she didn't believe me. She got a bit spooked up a bit, but you know, she wasn't let in that she was a bit scared, but she thought I was paranoid. Obviously I seen it from my own eyes, she didn't. But that was another creepy experience. Yeah, I had another experience then. I was lying on the sofa, nodding off, and I just opened my eyes, and then within seconds, right down the left side of me was a white wall in between me and the other half of the room. So when I looked, it was just all white. It was like someone just put a white wall there. It was absolutely scary as anything. I couldn't move much because I felt like I was frozen. And I could sense that there was a woman on the other side of the room, because I had two sofas, that she was on that sofa. And she was sat there, and she was around about late 20s. She had brown hair. And she was talking, but I couldn't understand her at first. So I asked her which she went, "You don't know me, and you can't see me. You can hear me, and you can just about feel me. So put your hand out." So I put my hand out, and from my fingertips to where my daughter's name was, all I just went icy cold, like a hand that was icy cold touching my hand. And then within minutes then, it disappeared. The white wall went, and that woman, she disappeared. It was like time had stood still at one point, and then back to normal, back to reality. That was freaky, really, really freaky. There was another experience I had in the house, and it would be in my bedroom. There would be a negative male presence there. It always happened in the night, and he'd be standing in between my wardrobe and a radiator constantly, but it felt like he was gonna grab me. But this is always in the night time. So what it was, where my bed was, I wouldn't walk right around it. I'd skim my whole body going around the actual bed, because I was scared that he'd end up putting his hands up and grabbing me. It was that phobia. And the people that come to my house, I tell them about that as well. And they kind of like picked up on it, about that negative presence in the room. It was another experience then I had when I'd be in the bathroom, and I'd hear a little girl, and she would be calling me mammy, mammy. And my daughter would not even be in the house at the time. She would be over my nan's, or over my mum's, or over her nan's. So I thought that would be a bit freaky, and it constantly keep on.
It's
and on
13
and on.
Hours.
And it was freaky. You know, she'd be sat in the bathtub. I wouldn't see her, but her voice would come in as if that direction, as if she was in the bathtub calling me. And it'd be times when my daughter was there, and it happened then, but she never picked up on anything like that, thank God. So that was another maddening experience for myself. Because things was going on in the house so much, I had to have a paranormal investigation team come in. And they go through the house and stuff, and they tell me then there was a portal in the house, and they blame it on me for doing what I used to do as witchcraft, but it's not the bad type of witchcraft. It was like protection spells and like cleansing rituals and stuff, nothing bad at all. So it was a bit like Wicca. But they'd say that there's a portal in the house and you have to come and ask someone to sort that out. But they also didn't know until I had someone come out that it was ley lines behind the actual house. So that can bring paranormal manifestations into the house. So yeah, that was another mad thing to find out about that house, that what happened. The house before I moved into this one, I had few problems with my children. When staying in their room, they both picked up on a male that was constantly just staring at them in there. And so I moved them in into a different room. And it'd be in the nights that when the door was closed, I'd go past it to go to the bathroom or to go downstairs. And it'd be the feeling of an army man standing in that doorway as if he was just going to grab me. A bit similar to the previous house, but he was an army guy. He was like a negative type of male. But this one, as if he was trying to reach out, but I felt scared. But obviously nothing had happened until I went in the attic and I found an old army photo, and I phoned up some people about it and no one could claim it. So then I put it up online and a male started mailing me, and he said he was one of them in the photo and he claimed it. And since that man had added that photo, that male presence, he was no longer there, he'd gone. But yeah, that was another scary bit of an experience that I had. And for my children to be scared was alarming. But I'm glad he went then. It was also another experience that my one daughter, she'd be in her room and my youngest would be in her crib when she was only a little baby. And because I had the crib right by me and I'd face that way anyway. As I opened my eyes, underneath it looked like a big puddle of blood. And mother's instincts, you get up, turn the light on and check. And it was nothing there. It was as if something wanted me to see something that wasn't there. You know, gay mother instincts, paranoid and stuff. But I seen a pile of, like a pool of blood underneath and dripping blood coming from there. Oh, it was absolutely horrifying. But then to check on my daughter, she was fine. She's breathing okay, sleeping, she's fine, really content, and no blood being under there. Words cannot describe the feelings that I went through at the time. It was something out of this world. Yeah, and so glad my daughter was okay, like, it was like something wanted me to see that, like some presence. I had another paranormal experience in this home. When I first moved in, there would be shadow figures I keep seeing coming in and out of the kitchen and living room. And they'd be literally pacing back and forth, back and forth, back and forth all the time. And it did my head in. And then it'd come into the living room and go across the wall. And it'd just stay there then. And then it'd go. And it'd be like that for a few times. So yeah, and I'd sit on my sofa and I'd have like someone sitting next to me. So I wasn't sure if it was a previous owner that died in here and wasn't found for like 3 to 5 days. He had an heart attack, God bless his soul. And there's times when I try and talk to him and say, you're more than welcome to come visit as long as you come in peace and don't bring no negativity in the house. I said, yeah, it was yours for a very long time, but now I'm the owner of this house. And it went from there. So stay tuned now for part 4. Hope you enjoy my content. If you really like it, please like and subscribe. Yeah, and looking forward to another part on my experience. So